Hello, this is Amethyst Lunatari, the RPG chick, and yes, it is not December 10th yet. It is the 8th. I got a couple things, quick things to talk about. I guess it won't be that long. Just about my week hiatus, which is over, and hopefully for good, knocking on wood. And my schedule, including Cyberpunk 2077. I have it downloaded. There's a day one patch that also have to download before we can play, I believe, which I hear is 70 gigs on top of everything. I'm not sure. It was like 59 gigs, I think, now. But this is the screen you see if you play, if you start the, if you double click on Cyberpunk 2077, this comes up. So, and Johnny is the character that Keanu Reeves plays. But anyway, yeah, I've been hearing good things about it. Just don't get your expectations too high and stuff. Other than that, yeah, just a week hiatus. I was off, and having issues at work. Not having to do with me, just having to do with people. But that's not what did it. It's more of a home issue that, which I'm like, I can't record right now. This is just too upsetting. It would not be fun, and it would just, yeah. You'd be like, why do you sound like you're a mess as you're playing Baldur's Gate? You know, just couldn't do it. But I'm back, and I'm trying to keep a backlog of videos for, you know, in case something like this happens again, if I want to take a week off or something like that, I can. Of course, it's not going to work with Cyberpunk 2077 for a few days anyway, because I have to build up my backlog of that. So I am glad to be back. It was only for a week, I believe, or a week and a day, something like that. And things are looking good. Now, as far as Cyberpunk 2077, I am going to be putting that up. Well, we can start playing it. You know, I'm in the Eastern time zone. I'm in New York. So I could start playing it technically on 6 p.m. But I have work. So I won't be able to get a video up until the early morning of the 10th. What I plan on doing is putting up a video early morning of the 10th, as soon as, you know, I can play, you know, process the video, upload, have it completely uploaded, you know, and I want it to be in 1080p when it goes live. So I'm not sure when that will be. I'm not sure what the first video will be. It might just be, you know, an intro cinematic and character creation. I don't know. I don't know how in-depth the character creation is going to be. So that's going to be video one, early hours on the 10th, Eastern Standard Time going by. And then I'm going to put another video up on 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on the 10th. So you're going to have two videos. And what we're going to do is we're going to have 7 days of Cyberpunk. It's going to be out daily, starting the 10th, 11th, 12th, 13th, 14th, 15th, and 16th. And then starting the 17th, Arena will be back, and it will be alternating with Arena until Arena is done. Arena's getting near the end. And then Cyberpunk will be daily again until something else happens, which might be Vampire the Masquerade, Bloodlines 2. So, and then it would alternate with that. I hear it's kind of a longish game, not as long as The Witcher 3, but like could be a 200-hour game or almost, something like that. So that's what that is. I'm just trying to get a bunch of videos out, and it's going to alternate with Arena. Because I know some of you guys really like the Arena videos. I find it to be a slog sometimes. It's funny because I don't feel like play. I often don't feel like playing it. But once I am playing it, then I'm into it, if that makes any sense. It's not like while I'm playing it, I wish I could, you know, play something else. Once I'm playing it, I'm there. It's just getting myself up to it. I'm talking about Arena, the Elder Scrolls Arena. So, and as far as my other Let's Plays are going to continue alternating at 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, which is Enderal, Forgotten Stories, the Skyrim mega huge mod, which I think is better than Skyrim, and alternating with Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition, which right now I'm playing through the Black Pits additional content and then getting back to the main quest. So, and as far as the thirds, so then you've got, you know, you've got videos alternating, you know, at 2, and videos alternating at 5. So every other day, different game at 2 and at 5. So I got 4 games going. And plus is Amber Moon at 8 p.m. on Saturday and Sunday. Can't forget Amber Moon. And really enjoying that game as well. Now, as far as 8 p.m. on the weekdays, I usually make it a shorter game. Sometimes an adventure game. Usually an adventure game. Could be a dungeon crawler. You know, and that's this and that. So that's when I'm caught up with everything. I need to be caught up with all 6 games. Have a good backlog. That's including Cyberpunk 2077, Amber Moon, Enderal, Baldur's Gate, and Arena. That's 6, right? Wait. Why do I think it's 5? Cyberpunk 2077. Oh, it is 5. Yeah, Amber Moon. Enderal. Arena and Baldur's Gate. Okay. Yeah, 5 games. So once that's caught up, we can add a 6th, which is my optional slot. I like to call it 8 p.m. That will be, weekdays. At 8 p.m. because the week ends 8 p.m. or Amber Moon. So, at some point I should, like, make some kind of chart or something like that. Maybe to make it easier to visualize. But anyway, that's that. So, you can expect some Cyberpunk 2077 videos from me. I'm super excited. I don't have... Oh yeah, this is the other thing I wanted to talk about. Roxanne 2.0. My rig I call Roxanne. It's a pink full tower. I have a video of me. You can find it on my video, an unboxing video. And in my miscellaneous playlist. But what I'm trying to do, I'm trying to upgrade the whole thing. What I'm doing is... I'm trying to reach a compromise because it's easier to retro game on Windows 7. At least last time I heard, a lot easier to play the old games. So I'm trying to keep a bridge between the old games and the new games. The last stuff I hear doesn't work with Windows 10 older things. They are being brought up to date, but sometimes I heard some emulators don't even work with Windows 10. So I want all the options available. So what I'm doing is I already ordered a motherboard, which will accept Windows 7. There's the newer ones, the USB devices, and maybe some other things don't work right. And so I got a new motherboard because my motherboard in this computer I've had since 2012. I have not changed the motherboard or the processor, so I'm getting... I actually already ordered, like I said, yeah, the motherboard and the processor, which is an i7 6th generation processor. I would have preferred to get an i9, but that doesn't work with Windows 7. So, those are on the way, being shipped to me. And there's a new NVIDIA RTX ray tracing card, 3060 Ti, pretty sure it is, and it's coming out Well, it's technically out, but sold out everywhere for $400. And I'm like, I can afford that. You know, I don't have to spend $700-$900 on a card. And this will have ray tracing, and this will help with Cyberpunk 2077. Although I hear the game runs smoother for a lot of people with the ray tracing off. I assume there's something I'm going to be fixing, but in any case, I do need a better card, because the card I have is like it's a GTX 970, so it's the one that has 3.5 gigs of usable RAM. The other 0.5 is like slow RAM or something. Doesn't really work. So the RTX 3060 Ti has 8 gigs, and it's faster and everything else, and I haven't changed my graphics card for 4 years, I think, so yeah, it's time for a new one. So, might have been 3 years. But when I got the graphics card I have now, the 970, it was not top of the line by any means. So, I just don't have the money to keep on top of this, all the latest stuff. So, the latest and the best, anyway. So, that's going to be, Roxanne 2.0, because I'm not going to change the name, because all the hard drives would be the same, although the hard drives have mostly been changed, except for the system drive. And, everything, the case will be the same. Other than that, everything else is going to be different, believe it or not. So, it's quite an overhaul we're going to be doing. So I'm waiting for that stuff to come, and I'm waiting for to be able to actually purchase this graphics card. Who knows when that'll be, but so my Cyberpunk 2077 videos are going to be with the old motherboard, old CPU, and old graphics card. And at some point, we're going to upgrade all those things, and then all of a sudden, the game is going to look so much more awesome. So have some patience with me. You're not going to see top-of-the-line graphics on mine, so I'm going to do the best I can. I heard people with similar setups working pretty good. They can run it like on high settings, and sometimes it might dip down to like 50 or 40 something frames a second, maybe adjust the shadows or something like that, and then that seems to improve things a lot. So, but that's it. That's my news, and I'll see you guys in the games, and always seek adventure.